For a little while now, I've been getting the same question from friends and viewers alike. Can I install Windows to my Mac, and is it hard to do? The answer is yes, and it's pretty easy to do. So today, we're going to be taking a look at how to do just that. Let's go over the list of stuff we're going to need to do this. First, you're going to need your Mac. It could be a Mac of any kind, like iMac, Mac Pro, Mac Mini, MacBook, MacBook Air, whatever. Second, you're going to need a DVD drive of some kind, and your Mac could have this built in. They haven't had those for quite some time, so you can just use an external one. You can find them for around $10 or $15. Third, and this one's free, you'll need a Windows 10 ISO from Microsoft. The ISO is basically just a disk file. And fourth, you'll need a blank DVD. Before anybody asks the question, yes, you can do this with a USB flash drive instead if you prefer to. I just have a bunch of these DVDs laying around and the drive, so I figured I might as well use it. First up on the list of stuff to do, we're going to partition the hard drive on our Mac, just because you don't really want anything running in the background on this because it moves around system files, and you know, you're moving around system files, you just don't want to mess around and play with fire, so we'll choose a safe route and do that first. Go ahead and open Disk Utility. And find your Mac's hard drive on the left side of the screen and click it. Then click the Partition button. Now shrink your Mac drive so you have space for Windows to install. And you probably want at least 50 gigs for Windows, at bare minimum like 30 just for the system, but if you do 30, you're not going to really be able to install anything. You'd want to do at least 50 or, you know, something like that, depending on how much you're going to use it. And once everything is partitioned out the way you'd like it, go ahead and click Apply, and then don't touch anything, just let it do its thing. After our partitioning is finished, we're going to go ahead and download Windows 10, and it can be as easy as just Google searching Windows 10 download, and you should see Microsoft show up as the first result. And now pick the versions of Windows 10 you want, and when it asks you if you want a 64 or a 32-bit download, pick 64 because Macs have had 64-bit chips since like 2008 or something like that, pretty early on, so most likely you have a 64-bit chip, so that's what you're gonna want. And this is a big download, so just let it sit and, you know, it'll take a while. Our last step before installing is just burning the disk image to our blank DVD, so go ahead and plug your DVD reader in if you need an external one. If you don't, go ahead and plop your DVD straight into your Mac. And find where you downloaded your Windows 10 ISO, right-click on it, and select Burn to Disk. Then just click Burn and let it do its thing. Now that the Mac is prepped and the DVD is burned, we're ready to install. Put the DVD in your Mac and power it off. Now, while holding the Option key, power your Mac back up. After a few moments, you should see the boot menu, and you should see your DVD drive there alongside with the Mac hard drive, so go ahead and click the DVD drive, and if it says hit any key to boot from DVD, just hit any key. Once you see the Windows 10 screen here, go ahead and keep advancing through the installer. If it asks you for a product key, just say I don't have one because you can always add one later. And once you get this screen where it asks you if you would like to upgrade or do something custom, do the custom option. Here comes the part where we need to remember how much we partitioned out, because if you delete the wrong partition here, you're going to either delete your macOS partition or you're going to make it unbootable. For some reason, what shows up as an empty partition to macOS shows up as a used partition to Windows, so if you just delete it and turn it back to unallocated space, you'll be able to install Windows just fine. Select the space that you partitioned out and then hit next, and then Windows will start installing. Congratulations if you've made it this far, because we're practically done now. The only thing left for you to do is just use your Windows copy now. And if you want to pick between macOS and Windows on boot up, you just have to hold the Option key. But anyways, thanks for watching. I hope this video helps for those of you who've been asking me for assistance. If you have any other questions, feel free to contact me through Twitter or through the YouTube comments. Make sure you subscribe if you're not already, and leave a like on the video if it helped. And I will see you all for the next one.